Who's on the telephone? There's a woman on the line. And this lipstick on his button down, and it sure as hell ain't mine. But it really ain't no matter, I've been hanging out next door, learning how to shoot a handgun and clean up blood off of the floors. I've been talking to the chief of our police, and I've been getting kinda cozy with the law enforcement, see. This is really Michael's fault, he's why I'm going to jail. But my lawyer said that's bullshit, won't hold up or get me bail. Well, I know her name is Baby and she lives at 503 Westbury Avenue on a quiet little street. So I got a little silencer, not too much more than free. And I might pay a visit to Michael's young baby. Then Michael came and told me the last thing I thought I'd hear. He said, I got this woman pregnant and I seen you acting weird. So I had to bite the bullet and I threw the gun away. It was mostly an idea mixed in with a bit of rage. I said, Michael, I'm leaving and it's best you let it be. And don't you do to baby as you've done to me. So I bought a one-way ticket and I went to Minnesota. And I spent all Michael's money and I picked up the telephone, huh? And I dialed up sweet baby, said, let me hear the cry. Cause I feel in some odd way that this child's partly mine. Well, then baby started sobbing and then she said to me, Michael's been a cheating and I've been flirting with the chief. I said, did you buy a handgun? She said, yes, that I did. But I threw it out once Michael said he was having another kid.